Hi, this is Chef Mick from Tony's Market. Welcome to my kitchen. Hams are one of mankind's oldest preserved foods. By drying with salt, meats are cured and can be stored without refrigeration. Very important historically. The Chinese have been curing ham since 4900 BC, and the practice spread through trade to early Rome and eventually throughout the globe and beyond. Prosciutto di Parma has even been brought into space to feed the astronauts. Ham refers to both the leg of pork and a curing process. A fresh ham is a raw leg of pork. There are smoked hams, wet hams, dry cured hams. The variation is mind-boggling. Join me in my kitchen as we explore how to select and serve a ham that's just right for you. There are a lot of hams out there, and some are much better than others. Being a small family market, we get to be picky. While our selection can change with each season, you could be confident we'll have some of the best hams in the country in a nice range of sizes and prices. Our house-glazed, bone-in, spiral-sliced ham is our perennial bestseller. They're consistently lean, tasty, tender, and juicy, and most agree the sodium level is just right. This is a half ham from the shank end, generally about 8 or 9 pounds each. The sirloin half looks just a little different, but I don't find one to be better than the other. Whenever possible, we also bring in American Kurobuta hams, also known as Berkshire, the best tasting breed of pork in the world. This is a half bone-in ham from the sirloin end, and these are not pre-sliced. But with just a center bone to deal with, slicing's pretty easy. We've also got a mini bone-in ham. This is just right for a couple or a small family. This mini bone-in ham is unique. It's a center cut with just a short section of bone down the middle here. I've only seen it from this particular farm and I love it. This breed of pork is simply superior to any other thanks to its shorter muscle fibers, better marbling, and more generous levels of collagen. They do cost more, but I always choose Kurobuta or Berkshire when it's available. We also always offer at least one boneless ham. Here I have a pre-sliced mini boneless ham. They're as easy as ham gets. We usually offer a couple of different sizes. This used to be a big category for us, but these days most folks choose bone-in hams. They just make such a huge impression at the table. Smoked hams are fully cooked. You can eat them cold, at room temperature, or warm. To warm, I suggest a low 275 degree oven and only about 10 to 12 minutes per pound. The goal is to just warm them. 120 degrees is perfect. 140 degrees at the very most. Any hotter will dry it out. Warming is simple. Rest the ham for 1 to 2 hours before cooking. Preheat the oven, add our foil wrapped ham flat side down, add water, and warm in the oven. In less than 90 minutes, this 8.5 pound ham was at 120 degrees internal, just right. Do watch the water level. I used about 2 cups in total, ending up with a cup or so of tasty stock in the pan. Hams that don't come pre-wrapped in foil should be simply out of the pan with water, or some folks use stock, fruit juice, or even ginger ale. Then cover with foil or parchment and foil, and warm just the same. Being covered, I only need to add about 3/4 cup of water. I think stuffing is a natural serve with ham, and we always have homemade stuffing on hand. I rolled some into balls and cooked in muffin cups, misting with olive oil and our roasted pork and poultry rump. They turned out really nice and with very little effort. We torch glaze our foil wrapped hams by hand, but maybe you want more or you have a different ham. Here's a simple recipe. Combine 1 cup of brown sugar, 1/2 cup of honey, 1 tablespoon each of butter, apricot jam, and apple cider vinegar, a small to a large spoonful of bold mustard, pinches of ginger, cinnamon, chili powder, cloves, allspice, and juniper berries, or just skip any spices you don't have. Bring to a boil and simmer a few minutes, and it's ready to brush on. You can simply brush this or any glaze on the ham right before you serve. Or to glaze in the oven, remove the ham near the end of cooking time, about 110 to 115 degrees internal, and turn the oven up to 425 degrees. Once the oven is hot, uncover the ham, slather on the glaze, and move it back to the oven to sizzle and glaze, maybe 5 minutes or so. Stay close by. Sugar glazes and browns quickly, but it can also burn before you know what happened. If you like to add a little showmanship at the table and you have a butane torch, you can simply sprinkle or pack with the ham and brown sugar and sizzle it with the torch. In between the smell of the ham, the caramelizing brown sugar, and the visual impact of the flame, your guests are likely going to go wild. In this case, I double glaze, but do it the way you like. Once out of the oven, rest about 10 minutes before slicing. Or if you have more to do, cover with parchment or foil and a kitchen towel, and it'll stay warm for 30 minutes plus while you get everything else ready and set the table. not start slicing until you're ready to serve, so it comes to the table nice and warm. Slicing these mini bone-in hams is easy. Simply cut down to and around the sides of the bones from one end to the other. Then turn it on its side and cut around the bone to release it from the meat. There's likely to be some slices still partially attached. Simply cut them apart when you do the final plating. For a full-size bone-in ham that's not pre-sliced, I do it much the same. Carve some from the top half and then turn and carve some from the bottom half. I paired this ham with a nice wedge of our scalloped potatoes, our roasted vegetables, and the dressing muffin we made. Then I drizzled with a little of the pan stock, a little more glaze, or you could even try our house gravy. Kurobuta, also known as Berkshire, is the best pork I've ever had. It's juicy, has a bigger and better flavor, and has a truly satisfying chew thanks to higher levels of collagen, a protein that's incredibly healthy for your skin, hair, nails, teeth, bones, ligaments, blood vessels, etc. Our spiral sliced ham is also quite delicious, and I think superior to all the others in town. I find it lean and particularly tender, and I like how it's not over salted or filled with water. It's already sliced. We just have to get those slices off the bone. The ham is essentially par-sliced. The machine I use can't cut right up against the bone, so you've got to make some cuts to free it up. I'll start by slicing around the bone with a knife tip, and then cut to free each slice one by one. This is an old school ham, so you've got to adapt and adjust as needed. As usual, stay patient and don't let yourself get frustrated. A patient, gentle hand will be the best and fastest way to do this, so don't rush. It took me 6 minutes from start to finish. I'll slice this ham from end to end so you can see how I do it, but I usually only slice enough for supper, leaving the rest on the ham to sort out later. I usually save any scrappy pieces for soups and then serve the prettiest slices for the first meal. You can move this to a hot serving plate and drizzle with the hot pan stock, or I like to just move it back to the pan of hot stock. It can also be covered and held in a low oven if needed. I also like to finish with a hearty drizzle of my homemade glaze. There's just something magical about savory smoked meats with sweet sauces. While ham is a very special holiday meal in our house, it's the soup I make later that I really go crazy over. We'll use these bones to make a great batch of soup in another video coming soon, so stay tuned. Born out of a need to preserve meats before the advent of refrigeration, hams have become a favorite food in cultures all over the world. Today, there's an incredible array of ham products, from the super premium options we carry at Tony's to chunked and formed pseudo-hams that are mostly water. Which ham is right for you? Boneless? Bone-in? Spiral slice? Kurobuta? Once you decide, give us a ring and we'll get you a really nice one. I'm Chef Mick from Tony's. I thank you for shopping in our markets, and I thank you for joining me in my kitchen.